Hey everyone, my name is Khushi Sharma and finally, here is my first video on my own YouTube channel. I'm really excited about it. But before we get started, let me give you all a quick introduction. So I'm Khushi and I'm currently a computer science sophomore from India. I love contributing to communities and that's also what this channel is going to be about. We'll be talking about communities, but at the same time, we'll be learning and building some amazing stuff together. So, what are we waiting for? Let's get started. So, today's video is inspired by someone whom I admire a lot, and that is Eddie Jaur. So, Eddie recently did a video on his channel about how we can create a JavaScript Discord bot with an open source NoSQL database. And today, what we'll be doing is something similar to that. So, we'll be getting started with that database, which is DataStax Astra. So, in case if you haven't watched Eddie's video until now, go and check out my description box below and you'll be able to find the link to his video. And while you are there, do subscribe to his channel as well. And for this video, let's get started. So today, we are going to learn more about DataStax Astra and see how we can build something out of it in just a couple of minutes. To begin with, what is DataStax Astra? Now, what if I tell you it's just a distribution of Apache Cassandra? Wow, a whole new another term, right? Cassandra. Now what is this about? Let me break it up to you. So Cassandra is actually an open source distributed database management system. So we can visualize database as somewhere we store our data and we can even access it easily. While a distributed database is available at multiple computers at once, which makes it easier for us to interact and even handle large amounts of data at one go. But what if I told you that you can actually create a cluster with the push of a button within a UI for free? Seems attractive, right? And that's exactly why we are using DataStax Astra today. It provides us the ability to develop some data-driven applications and even deploy them without the hassles of any infrastructure administration. So for today's part, we're going to learn more about how to use DataStax Astra and how we can build something out of its very easy examples. So now, to get started, we'll open our browser and we'll go to the link which is mentioned in the description box below. Now, clicking to the link will redirect us to a page like this. And this is the web page for DataStax Astra. Now here, we can sign up for free and we'll get a $25 free credit every month, which gives us around 40 GB of storage. So we can sign up either by giving our custom credentials, or the other way would be to sign up with GitHub or either with Google. So I'll quickly sign in as I already created my account. I'll sign in here with GitHub and this will redirect me to the official dashboard of DataStax Astra. So now I'm redirected to my dashboard and here you can see a lot of related information. So now you'll notice while you'll be creating your account, you can select the pay as you go plan and you'll also get $25 credits free every month, which turns around 40 GB of storage. Now this dashboard also records your lifetime usage of all the databases. You'll get a record of your read request, write request, the storage consumed and the data transfer. Going down, we can see we have a record of our databases that we've already created. So here is a database which I've already created. I can see the related statistics of it on its right side. And as I told you earlier, we'll be implementing a DataStax example today. Now for that, we'll again go to our browser and search DataStax examples over here. And we'll go to the first link which comes out. Now the same link is also mentioned in the description box below. So you can check that out for direct access. So this is more like a library of code and applications which can help us predefine some projects with DataStax and Apache Cassandra. And as we scroll down, we can see the example V and we get a few more examples over here. But the one which we are going to implement today is this Todo app using Jamstack, Netlify and AstraDB. So a Todo app is usually a React application where we can list all the things that we want to do in a day or maybe in a week. But today we'll be implementing it on a local machine with a DataStax Astra free tier database. To begin with, we'll click on this which says view on GitHub
So we'll be redirected to a GitHub template like this. So basically this is a GitHub template of the to-do application that we'll be implementing today on a local machine. So the first step to implement it would be to go back to our dashboard, and now we'll be creating our first database. So we'll be getting an option over here which says create database. We'll go on that and we'll be redirected to somewhat like this, which says create a database. And we are asked to enter our basic details, the first one being database name. So you can give it any name. I'm gonna name it as to-do applicator, to-do app. Let's just keep it to-do app. And you will also have to give it a key space name. So basically the key space will be reflecting your data model. So I'm just gonna keep it to-do key space. Oops. And you can see the current plan here is pay as you go. And after that we'll be asked our provider and region. So I'll be selecting the provider as Google Cloud, and the region. So basically the region would be the nearest locality or nearest region from your location right now. So mine would be this. And after this is done, I'll just click on this create database option. And yeah, I have created my database. But how you can see that you have? So basically you will be able to see this to-do app, the name of the database that you gave under the databases option on your dashboard. But one thing would be here is that the status of the database would be pending for now. It's not active or it's not in the green color like the above one is. So basically it takes some time to change its status from pending to active. But until then, I'll show you quickly about how a database looks like. So I've already created a database which is named as my first database. And when I click on that, I'll get all the statistics related to that. I'll get its region, its key space, and I'll get its cluster ID here as well. And this is a SQL console, basically where we can interact with our database. And this is the settings option, which basically where we can create our application token. So we'll see what an application token is and how do we create one when our to-do app will get active. And we can even terminate this database and park this database as well. So the to-do app is active and we'll go there. And the region is Asia South one and the provider is Google Cloud. So now the next thing that we'll be doing here is to generate an application token for this. So for that we'll go to settings. So basically application token would be used when we'll be implementing the project from GitHub. For that what we'll do is we'll say looking to manage your token. So basically we'll go to this organization settings option, and here you can see the option is to generate a new token. Now to generate a new token we'll have to select a particular role, because for that role certain permissions will be associated with it. So make sure that you select the role admin user. And you click on generate token, and yay, your token has been generated. So you can see the client ID, client secret, token, but at the same time I'll also download the CSV. So basically this is the only time that we'll be seeing our client ID, client secret and token. So I'll download this CSV because we'll be needing it when we'll implement it on our local machine. And you can see this is the token. So make sure that when you will download your CSV, the one that would be starting from Astra CS is your application token. So now once we have created our application token, we'll get back to our dashboard and we'll go to this to-do app database. And after this, we'll go to this connect option over here. And as you can see, we can connect to our database using REST API, GraphQL API, or the document API. Or we can also download the secure connect bundle that can help us connect with different data stacks drivers. What we are gonna do right now is copy this information. So we can say copy to clipboard option over here, and we can just save it somewhere, maybe in a Word document or in a text file. So just make sure that you save it somewhere, because we'll be needing this once we'll start implementing it on our local machine. And now what we'll be doing is we'll go back to the GitHub template, and once we get back to it, we can see this option which says use this template. So we'll click it over here. And so what we are doing right now is we're creating a new repository from that particular template named to-do Astra Jamstack Netlify. So I'm just gonna write it as to-do app. I'm going to keep it public and I'm going to include all the branches. And this says create repository from template. So I'm going to do that. And it's creating the particular repository. And as we can see here, the repository from that particular template is created. And now we'll clone this repository onto a local machine. So to clone this repository, we'll check this option which says code, and for this we're going to copy the link to this repository. So make sure that you select the HTTPS option and you'll have the link. This is the link to your repository that you are currently into. I'm just going to copy that and I'm going to clone it. So what does clone means? That it means I'm just copying this whole repository from GitHub onto my local machine. So to clone the repository, I'm going to open my terminal. So opening a terminal, and so right now I'm using pwd command to check on which directory I am. So I'm going to navigate to desktop. So basically what I'm trying to do is I just navigated to a directory which says desktop. So right now onto my local machine, I'm on my desktop, and now I'm just going to clone it. So to clone the repository, we are going to write git clone. And we're going to paste the link of the repository that we just copied. So it says cloning into Todo app and it has already cloned it. So when I'll open my desktop now, I would be able to see a folder named Todo app. So once we have cloned the repository, now we're going to move to this particular repository that we just cloned, or the folder that just got created onto my desktop. So I'm going to write first what we can do. We can write as ls. Basically what matters to me is this Todo app which just got created on my desktop, and I'm just gonna write the exact thing over here, which is Todo app, and I am on this repository which is Todo app. So I just cleared that whole bunch of things, but yeah. So right now what we did was, we are right now, if we see in which directory we are, so it says Todo app, we just got into that directory. And basically now what we're going to do is, so the Todo app and, or the Todo project that we just cloned, it uses some node dependencies. When we are cloning it into our local machine, we have to install all those dependencies. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to write npm install. And basically when I write this, now it's gonna take a lot of time. So this is after all of the dependencies have been installed. It just took around 5 to 6 minutes, so you can wait until all the dependencies are installed over there. Now the next thing that I'll be doing is, so I'm gonna open Visual Studio Code. So Visual Studio Code, yeah, and from here I'm gonna open the folder. So when I click on open folder, what I'm doing is I'll be clicking the folder or the repository that I just cloned onto my desktop. So I'll go to desktop and I'll go to the folder or the repository that I just cloned, and I'll open it here. So basically what I'm doing is I'm just kind of opening the repository or the folder that I just created on my desktop to this Visual Studio Code. And this so basically this is the whole repository that was there on GitHub, and now it's there in on my local machine, and I'm using it on my VS Code or the Visual Studio Code. Now here the one thing that I want you all to see is we have a .env template file over here. So .env template file, it consists all of our environment variables that we had when we were trying to create our database. So we copied a list of variables, and now is the time when you're going to use that. So what you're going to do is you're going to go back to our terminal. I'm quickly going to write clear, otherwise you won't be able to see anything. And what we're going to write is you're going to write cp.env template.env. So what are we doing here is, we just saw that we have a file which is named as .env-template. What I'm doing is I'm just copying all the content of this file and into this new file that would be created in the same folder, which is .env. So once I do this, and here we can see I get a new file created which says .env. And once I open this file, I can see that this is the same data that I just copied, but it just has a replace me thing where we'll be replacing all this information. So now the next thing that we'll be doing is we'll be replacing all the information that we copied from our database section and we're going to use it here along with the application token. Now, how can we access the application token? Remember, when we were generating an application token, we downloaded the CSV for all the related data. So what you can do is you can go to that CSV, you can just find out that CSV in your downloads and you can just copy the application token. But the application token, remember, it starts from Astra, so you can copy the whole thing and you can just copy it all over here. So now I've quickly copied all the information with the Astra database ID, the Astra database region, key space and my application token. And once I'm done with this, I'll go back to my terminal. And this would be a pretty much last command, and I'm gonna write npm run dev. So this is the command now that is gonna execute and implement our whole project. And it says injected.env file in environment variable. So this is the file that we created. So what we did was we just tried to connect all of our database details or the database that we created on DataStax Astra, and we put that into a .env file. And what we did was we tried to implement that on our local machine. And now once we are done with that, we can see that we are redirected to a localhost page like this. And yeah, so it says the same thing. It says Astra React.js to do demo. It says to do's, what needs to be done. So let's see how we can like functionalize it even. So if I say work with Auro. But yeah, it says work with Auro, and for example, if I've done that, I just tick on it and even I can cancel it. And that's an amazing to-do app which we just implemented on a local machine using DataStax Astra, and we connected our database using .env file and we saw how to do it. What if we do want to change something in it? So if you just want to change or make a slight change to this whole project, what you can do is you can again go to a VS Code. I'm going to go to the header.js. So in the header.js, I can see it's written what needs to be done. So this is basically this thing, what needs to be done. So I can just change it. And maybe I can write, hey, what all are you doing today? And I'm just gonna save it. And yeah, it says, hey, what all are you doing today? So it gets reflected over here. But I would definitely prefer you to also try developing this whole project from scratch. And this was it for this video. I had a lot of fun creating this content for all of you, and today we saw how to use DataStax with one of its examples. But what I'm planning is to develop an application from scratch for the next part. What's it? Let me know in the comment section if you want another part of this video. And if you liked what you saw, do like this video and also share it with someone you think would benefit from it. Also, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and I'll meet you soon. Bye!